Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Or if you're new, hey, how's it going? My name is Nicole and this is my wacky life.
1, 2, 3,
fuck it.
This video is going to be real because we're going to talk about some body positivity. We're going to be talking about body image, your relationship with like a scale, and just like, I don't know how to even explain it. I just feel like it's something that's been on my mind lately. I just need to make a video about this, if that makes sense. With that being said though, let's just go ahead and dive straight into body positivity. First off, why it's been on my mind lately. I always keep things 100% real. If you have not seen my self-love series before on this channel, I highly recommend checking it out just because it showcases just like how real and honest I get in these videos. Body positivity has been on my mind a lot lately because, being completely honest, I've had such an unhealthy relationship when it comes to body image. Most importantly, I guess my body image, if we're being specific. Like, I don't know necessarily like how to explain it, except for the fact that I have for so long have let like how much I weigh when I go on my scale define my happiness with my figure. I have such a bad relationship sometimes with food, with binge eating, with like the terms that I use when I describe myself. Like if I tell myself like I need to stop eating so much, I say things like or else I'm gonna get fat. And I don't think I've realized how much I've used the word fat as a way of shaming my body image or scaring me from doing certain things, or for that being my motivation to do certain things. But let me not ramble and like not make any sense in this video, but pretty much just saying like, first off, for so long I have let the scale define my happiness with my weight. I never came to terms of acceptance that my body is constantly changing. I was not going to continue weighing 125 for the rest of my life. I always weighed 125, and that really took a turn and changed when I worked in an office job with my best friend and I was in complete denial too about how my body was changing. I saw in everything that even though my pants were getting tighter, I saw in everything like that I was so morphed with this idea that I wasn't gaining weight and that I was perfectly fine. Pretty much like self-denial and like making my body suffer too, because I would continue wearing these extremely tight pants that were just hurting me. I mentioned that because it was at that point that my body weight took a turn and 125 was no longer a thing for me, because I gained about 15 pounds working at an office job. Once I realized I had gained the weight, I saw the scale and I was not happy with the fact that I didn't weigh 125 anymore. So I was putting myself under this constant pressure that I needed to be more active, I needed to go to the gym to lose weight, I needed to be careful of how much I was eating. In a sense, like putting all these restrictions on my body. I think I finally had got myself down to 130. I settled for that and I was like, that's fine, because I would look in the mirror and I liked how I looked. I was putting myself under so much pressure, which does not surprise me that I'm able to recognize that, because I for the longest time have such a bad struggle with putting so much pressure on myself. I'm always so hard on myself. Going further, I've had this just really unhealthy relationship with like the scale. I remember I went on vacation to Atlanta and I would see pictures of myself. I was like, is it because I'm wearing stripes in this shirt that I look wider, or is it because I'm wearing a bodysuit that I look wider? And I came home like extremely pissed off with how I looked, because I felt like it was such a bad thing. Like, so like I came back home and I was like, no, like screw this, I'm gonna lose the weight. Started doing intermittent fasting, hitting the gym every day. It's crazy the way I would think that I needed to lose this weight. Trying to process this all without getting super emotional of thinking about it. I'm glad though that I'm able to sit here in front of this camera right now and say I've recognized that I've had this long-term unhealthy relationship with the way I viewed my body. So needless to say, I'm super incredibly thankful to be living where I am now in Colorado. Just shout out to my roommates in general, but also just shout out to my roommate Christina, because she showed me this Instagram account of this girl who just, in a sense, like I don't know, like her whole page just kind of screams just like body positivity and like embracing your body, working out for the right reasons, and just like such a healthy mentality. And it wasn't until like seeing this that I think I was able to make the connection of just how unhealthy of a relationship I had with my body image. I need to also recognize and kind of like break up with this mentality that I had that being skinny meant that I was healthy or meant that my figure was good. It's just nonsense. I was gonna say another word, but we're gonna say nonsense to just keep it. Just because my body's skinny or I have abs or I have the curves that I want or I look super thin when I look in the mirror to the side, like if I look in the mirror sideways like this, just because I'm like this, like that doesn't mean that I'm healthy, that I'm strong. Like it did not mean the things that I thought it meant. I may weigh 140, but I'm out here going on hikes, like I'm not gonna say like crazy intense hikes because my body's not at that physical level yet. I went on a hike the other day with my mom while I was out here, and I did that. I did like an almost 2,000 and almost 3,000 elevation gain hike. Like I went on a really intense hike with all my friends here. I did that. Like my body is capable of doing that, and I need to appreciate things like that. If I'm going to the gym, it's to improve my health, not because I need to lose weight. When I go to the gym and I do my cardio, if my goal is to always do a mile in cardio, my goal should be to enhance how long I can jog before having to stop within that mile, and timing that and seeing if I can equal my time or beat my time, because that's improving my health. I felt like sharing this just because like I feel like this is not something only I struggle with. I need to be happy with my body. I'm gonna just say this like openly and proudly, like I am a freaking amazing person. Like I am a beautiful woman inside and out. I don't know what else to say. I feel like I'm a little bit rambling, but your scale should not define your happiness. You know, I have my thick legs, and like I need to not be ashamed of it. Embrace my body, love my body. I'm done with that unhealthy relationship. So this is my way of saying I'm breaking up with being so hard on myself. I'm breaking up with my toxic behaviors, and I couldn't be happier to just be able to recognize all the healing that I'm doing internally in my heart, my mind, and my body. Yeah, just wanted to share that with you guys. This is my roommate Christina.
Hello.
And I figured I'd ask her if she wanted to drop any knowledge on body positivity, since you are the main roommate of inspiration for me and my healing. So I figured I'd ask you.
I guess just to keep it brief, I just find it so important to celebrate all of the things that your body can do instead of necessarily what your body looks like. I know that's really... it's a lot easier said than done, but just think about how many miles you can walk in a day and how blessed you are to be able to do that. I mean, some people don't even have that ability. You know, you hiked 6-7 miles, that's amazing. Yeah. Your body is just so incredible and multifaceted, and there's so much more to you than the number that you see on the scale kind of staring back at you. I think celebrating everything that you can accomplish in your lifetime is so much more meaningful than what your body looks like today or tomorrow. I mean, it changes every day. Never gonna look the same all the time.
Well, thank you.
Yeah,
for sharing that. It's so true though, like it's crazy, but that's why I figured I'd ask you to share, because I feel like I didn't realize I was struggling so much with it until like you started like helping me, mm-hmm. and calling me out on the negative things I said, which it helps. Like, I mean, it may not help everybody for that kind of way, but it helped me at least, like to recognize how badly I was like.
Yeah, you just get into like a trained mindset, you know, you yeah. start saying these self-deprecating things about yourself, you don't really realize that you're even saying it. And yeah. I didn't mean to call you out. I just wanted you to know that I think that you're beautiful and that you shouldn't be so hard on yourself. Really. Everyone struggles with something. I mean, especially yeah. being a woman in these times, it's really hard to just, you know, not be stick thin. Nothing against thin people.
Yeah, no, nothing
against
no shaming against you thin people. But
if you don't fit within the beauty standard, it's just, it's really hard. Just want to support you and love you.
I appreciate it. This is the amazing Christina, guys.
She's gonna edit me out.
No, I'm not. With that being said, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. Comment down below. If you're not subscribed, subscribe to my channel. I do post videos every Wednesday and Friday. I will see you guys on Friday. Thank you so much for watching. This is your favorite, Wacky Mackey, signing off. Bye. Show you love, show you love, show you love. Show you love, show you love, show you love.